Hey guys, how y'all doing? Hope everybody's good. We are back to do reviews of Resident Evil Final Chapter and Triple X Return of Xander Cage. We're gonna start with Triple X Return of Xander Cage. I enjoyed it. This was what this franchise has turned out to be. You know, lots of action, lots of explosions, and you know, blowing shit up. And I thought the story that was told about why it was explained in the Triple X State of the Union with Ice Cube that Xander had died or had been killed. They explained that away in this one by having him say that, hey, you know, I faked my own death. You know, I faked my own death. So, you know, and it was kind of, so that was an interesting way to kind of explain that. Basically, this is just your basic kind of spy movie. This one had a lot more action than the first Triple X, and when I say the first Triple X, I'm not intentionally overlooking the second one. I'm talking about the two that specifically starred Vin Diesel. This one had a lot more action, and this one was a lot easier to follow, I thought, but, and I'm not going to give anything away, because I do think it's worth seeing if you like, you know, spy action, you know, car chases and love movies. And I think everything was done beautifully. The acting, the directing, the, you know, all the special effects, all that stuff was done beautifully. I'm gonna go ahead and give this one, for the action and just the, you know, James Bond-esque type of thing he had going on, 3.5 wheelies, and say, it's worth seeing, definitely. You know, check it out on like a Netflix or Amazon Video or a Hulu or wherever you get it, and if you like it based off of that, pick up the Blu-ray, the DVD. Great pickup for me, I liked it. 3.5 wheelies out of 5. Next, we had Resident Evil, the final chapter. So we're gonna get into that in just a second. Alright, sorry about that. I had to pause and take a couple drinks. Anyway, Resident Evil, final chapter. Now, this one to me was a disappointment because I had seen and I have all the other Resident Evil movies, and those were all excellent, excellent movies. This one, I couldn't even get through, which is sad because, like I said, I like the Resident Evil movies. I think that Mila Jovovich as you know, the character she does really well as, like, the reluctant hero. But something about this one was just off to me. And I feel like they probably could have stopped at the last movie and been good to go, but I'm glad they called this the final chapter, because after this, I don't think any more Resident Evil movies should be made. This one was definitely the weakest of the bunch. I couldn't get through it. I made it about 45 minutes and turned it off. So with that, I'm gonna go ahead and give it a wheelie and a half, and tell you guys skip it. The only reason I have it and I'm not gonna get rid of it is because I'm a fucking completist and it completes my set. And so there's that. But I probably won't watch it again, just because it's the weakest of the movies in the franchise. And I wouldn't recommend it to anybody. Unless, like me, you have the others and you are a completist, I wouldn't recommend it. Anyway, thanks for watching, thanks for listening, thanks for Fostering Creativity. I taught y'all I could do this, so I appreciate y'all more than you ever know. I love y'all, I'll be back soon.